You'll all know this.
I close my eyes, drew back the curtains to see for certain what I thought I knew. Far, far away, someone was weeping and the world was sleeping. Any dream will do.
I wore my coat
with golden lining, bright colors shining, wonderful and new. And in the east, the dawn was breaking, and the world was waking. Any dream will do.
In order to raise some more funds for Orpheus and he chose this one to recite.
Paula, the caterwauler. Paula was a cat who just loved to sing with a dreadful sound that made the ears ring. She gathered some like-minded cats to form a choir whose efforts and harmony were dreadfully dire. The cats were so pleased, they just didn't care. The neighbours were left in total despair. They tried using earplugs, but to no avail, for they still could hear the high-pitched wail. Unaware, it seems, of the distress they caused, all the cats loved it and clapped their paws. Paula was proud of her musical catwalling and looked upon it as a special calling. She soon found that in the world of pets, her fame was gaining considerable ground. She was so ambitious to spread the word, and she wanted the choir by all to be heard. She even made a surprising change to give the choir a more balanced range. She approached some dogs with a proposition to agree to come for a singing audition. Up to London, they all did then go with a plan to ambush a certain show. Up to London, they stealthily crept, and up to the stage, they cheekily stepped. The next day, the papers were full of the story of them drowning out Land of Hope and Glory. Thank you.
Is somewhere from West Side Story.
Yes.
Galway Bay. If you ever go across the sea to Ireland, and maybe at the closing of your day, you will sit and watch the moon rise over Clannad and see the sun go down on Galway Bay. Just to hear again the ripple of the trout stream, the women in the meadows making hay, and to sit beside a turf fire in the cabin and watch the barefoot gossams at their play. For the breezes blowing o'er the sea from Ireland are perfumed by the heather as they blow, and the women in the uplands digging praties speak a language that the strangers do not know. For the strangers came to try and teach us their way. They scorned us for being what we are, or they might as well go chasing after moonbeams or light a penny candle from a star. And if there's going to be a life hereafter, and somehow I'm sure there's going to be, I will ask my God to let me make my heaven in that dear land across the Irish Sea.
I'd like to thank everybody here who's made it possible for this evening to happen. So thank you very, very much.
I've got 10 seconds before the next lyric, I think.
Let's make a deal with our friends. We'll host them. We can in London, and we'll show them the country movie and give them a copy. And while we're at it, we'll make a new film, a new film. New film at London, create some memories of the city. We'll each have a copy. And we'll each have a copy.
And I guess there are 10 sopranos in the world who sing this aria, and 9 of them do it for about £10,000 a night, and Charlotte is doing it, bless her, for nothing for us tonight. Just got my first guitar, 200 miles away. Chris had just left the army, but we were both listening to Lonnie Donegan on the radio and thinking, oh, there is some music that we can play. Because up until then, it had all been difficult stuff. And suddenly skiffle came, and yeah, we could all manage it. Well, you'll see that we could nearly manage it.
Sweet 16 goes to church, just to see the boys. Laughs and screams and giggles at every little noise. Turns her head a little, and turns her head a while. But Ramona knows she's only putting on the style.
She's
putting on the agony, putting on the style. That's what all the young folks are doing all the while. And as I look around me, I sometimes have to smile. Seeing all the young folks putting on the style. My old man's a dustman, he wears a dustman hat. He wears coat, garnet, trousers, and he lives in a council flat. He looks a proper now, in his friendly hobnail boots. He calls them daisy roots. My Dixie darling, listen to the song I sing beneath the saloon with a banjo string tune. I love no one but you. My heart is only true, my Dixie darling, my Dixie Belle.
Oh me, oh my, oh me, whatever shall I do? Hallelujah, the question is peculiar. I'd give a lot of dough if I could only
the answer to my question is it yes or is it no?
Does your tune not lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? When mother says don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? And catch you round your tonsils and heave it left and right. Now chewing gum loses its flavour on the bedpost overnight.
She's putting on the agony, putting on the style. That's what all the young folks are doing all the while. And as I look around me, I sometimes have to smile. Seeing all the young folks
anyway, this is this song's only purpose is to contain every one of Don's unused rhymes. Here they are. Somewhere within earshot of old Bow Bell's chimes sits the Don Black Memorial Home for Old Rhymes. Outside looking in and in need of befriending, slowly approaching her feminine ending, begrimed and unrhymed lies Maxine. Poor Maxine had never had need of a rhyme. She spent her professional life as a which in the last rhymes with Maxine. I'll never be lonely, I'll join the Don Black scene. Maxine will be there, living under the care of the gently satirical lyrical miracle. He'll never write Tosca, but he has got an Oscar. The lyrical miracle known as Don
Complicated and unnecessary song. This is a proper song because it's very simple, and the best songs are very simple. Angus is going to sing it, and you're all going to join in, but not till the second verse. Right?